It may take an entire village to raise a child. It takes a body to be resurrected. In 191, verses 1 through 3.
Promptly obedient, they entered the temple again. Herod and went on with their teaching. Meanwhile, the chief priests and his cronies convened a high council, Israel's Senate, and sent to jail to have the prisoners brought in. When the police got there, they couldn't find them anywhere in the jail. Just then, someone showed up and said, "Did you know that the men you put in jail are back in the temple teaching the people?" The chief and his police went to got them, but they handled them gently, fearful that people would riot and turn on them. Bringing them back, they stood them before the high council. The chief priest said, "Didn't we give you strict orders not to teach in Jesus' name? And here you have filled Jerusalem with your teaching, and are trying your best to blame us for the death of this man." Peter and the apostles answered, "It's necessary to obey God rather than you. God, our ancestors, raised up Jesus, the one you killed by hanging him on a cross.
Hear
the Spirit
to
say to the church.
I am worthy of the United, one to the
mother. Amen." It's a reflection on the readings for today called "Let Me Meet You, God" by Norman Church. Let me meet you on the mountain, God, just once. You wouldn't have to burn a whole bush, just a few smoking branches, and I would surely be your Moses. Let me meet you on the water, God, just once. It wouldn't have to be on White Rock, God. Just a puddle after the Anglo-Dallas rain, and I would surely be your Peter. Let me meet you on the road, God, just once. You wouldn't have to blind me on North Central Expressway. Just a few bright lights on the way to chapel, and I would surely be your Paul. Let me meet you, God, just once, anywhere, anytime. Just meeting you in the Word is so hard sometimes. Must I always be your Thomas?
A reading from the Revelation to John. "I, John, with you all the way in this trial, in the beloved community of God, in the passion of patience in Jesus, is on the island called Patmos because of God's word, the witness of Jesus. It was Sunday, and I was in the Spirit, praying. I heard a loud voice behind me, trumpet clear, and piercing. Write what you see into a book. Send it to the seven churches throughout the land. I turned and saw the Lord. I saw a golden menorah with seven branches, and in the center, the Son of Man, in a robe and gold breastplate, hair of blue or white, eyes pouring fire blaze, both feet furnace-fired bronze. His voice a cedar, right hand golden seven stars. His mouth a sharp fighting sword. His face a pair of deep. I saw this, and thanks to the dead his feet. His right hand filled the upright. His voice reassured me. Don't fear. I am first. I am last. I'm alive. I died, but I came to life, and my life is now forever. See these keys in my hand? They open and lock death's doors. They open and lock those gates. Now write down everything you see. Things that are, things about to be. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
In 192,